First question, how many people have played around on our site before? How many people have never been to it and this is the first time you've ever seen the homepage? Okay, good. So first I will predicate all this by saying, as social media senior specialist here at C-SPAN, I am not the one in charge of the website, building the website. If there's an error, don't get mad at me. I am sort of the super user and can talk about it with outside groups. So if something doesn't work today, it's not my fault. I will make a phone call or really send an email because I don't like talking on the phone that much. So with that in mind, let's kind of take the quick tour. One, before we really jump into searching, I'm going to talk about the homepage. Usually, if something has happened today, if you're watching it, if you're trying to find something that's just happened, I'd say go to our homepage first before you start searching for it. Sometimes things aren't logged or all the technical things, you might search for something and it doesn't appear in the search yet. That's because the event's not even over yet. So before you start going through the search, I would go here to the homepage. So this morning's segments on the journal are all down here on the left. Other recent videos that have been on are all right down in here. And so I would tell you, Congress is not in session today, and so this is actually a pretty short list of things that we're covering live today on the networks. I think there's only, outside of the journal, three live events we're covering today. But tomorrow, I've already looked, and I think there's seven or eight. This is before the shoot meeting in 3:15, where they're going to decide on all of our coverage. And there are some days where Congress is in session with a number of briefings that there might be 20 events here on the left. And so before you search for those, I would say, look here on the homepage first. Cool? All right. If you don't, how many people here have a My C-SPAN account? A couple. It's entirely free, and we're going to go over clipping and all sorts of things today. But the first thing I would say to do is create an account, and therefore all the work you do on the site you won't lose. It'll all be stored in one place where you can find it, rather than keeping all your clips or things like that in a Word document or an Excel sheet somewhere. Okay. So I'm logged in, and we'll go from there. So, as Susan mentioned at the top, there's a lot of video here. There's 247,000 hours of video here. If you start watching this video right now and try to go through all of it, it'll take you a quarter of a century to watch. And so that's why we're going to focus on search today. How many people here were born before 1987? So for some of you, everything in your lifetime that's been on C-SPAN is here. When I have high school kids come in, I will ask them what their birthday is and go find out which press briefings were on C-SPAN that day. Sometimes people hosting the journal are sitting in the room at the same time, and it really doesn't bode well for me, so we won't do that today. Let's do a basic search. I'll just type in Pelosi. I'm going to stick with things that I can spell and type very easily today for this presentation. Obviously, Pelosi, a lot in the news last week, this week, you could say. Every single person has a bio page. If you type in any search term, there's all these categories for results: videos, clips, people, organizations. I typed in a person's name. There are 12 people named Pelosi, but sometimes that might mean Pelosi's part of their title. Let's click on here. It says 12 Pelosi's are in here. Advisor for Pelosi, staff member, office of Pelosi. So it doesn't necessarily mean it's their last name. We were looking for the most obvious, Nancy Pelosi, first one. Every single person that's on C-SPAN has a bio page just like this. Doesn't matter if they were on C-SPAN once or if they've been on C-SPAN thousands of times. If they're in Congress and you scroll further down, you're going to see appearances by year. What's their district look like? This page can't load Google Maps. Okay, great. So somewhere in, yeah, it's here in San Francisco. You can see votes. We're going to get to that in a little bit. I'm usually just looking for see all appearances. So Nancy Pelosi has, what's the number, 2,528 appearances. There are ways to narrow this down. Last week, the top video for us of Nancy Pelosi on Twitter was her getting the gavel from Leader McCarthy. And so that was our top video. Anybody want to guess what the second most viewed Pelosi video was last week for us?
Yeah. Her taking the gavel in 2007?
Exactly. Thank you. So earlier in the morning, I went and found the video of Nancy Pelosi getting the gavel in 2007. We're going to do that right now. So there are various ways to do this. I knew the date of it. So I'm going to go over here to the calendar. We're going to go to 2007. I'll just click on January 1st. I'm going to extend that search about a week to the 8th. There are 9 videos that week. We'll just look through. And here's election of Speaker Pelosi. This is just a segment. This isn't the whole election. They narrowed this down just to the speeches, 43 minutes. And I'm going to type in right down here the word gavel. And as we can see, speaker. I have the high privilege. This is Boehner speaking. We're going to scroll down here. Goes into the gavel. I'll click on that. It's automatically going to start playing the video up top.
Former Democrat Nancy Pelosi became the first woman to be elected Speaker of the House of Representatives.
Click it again.
Speaker in our history, the gentlelady from California, Nancy Pelosi.
All right, so I'm going to make a clip of this. We're going to hit clip down here in the left-hand corner. We are right now at the 1723 mark. So I want a few seconds before that. 1714 works. I think I'm going to go, let's do this, 1744. So it's just 30 seconds. We're going to preview clip.
To representatives, to the first woman speaker in our history, the gentlelady from California, Nancy Pelosi.
Pause it there. We're at 1733, so it doesn't even need to be 30 seconds long. Okay, I'm gonna hit next. We'll give a title description. I'm just gonna say gavel, but you can obviously use more words than that. Hit save clip. So now this says gavel, it's my title. Gavel is my description, it says it's created by me. And then if I hit play, it's just 21 seconds long.
The United States House of Representatives.
Same thing. I can go down here and I can download it if I want, which would go then to, if I go over here to my page, go to my clips, you can see Pelosi here, the gavel. And if we go to downloads, it's there as well. And then if we go to C-SPAN on Twitter, I'm not going to log in right now, but we're just going to keep going down. It's a busy week. Hold on. There's her getting the gavel. I think I used this in response to the first tweet. Yep. Here's the one from earlier.
Snap.
So I posted that at 9 o'clock in the morning. That's obviously West Coast time. And we got 44,000 views before they even gaveled in the session that day. That was kind of my, what am I going to do until they start? Because they started at noon and we had nothing else except Washington Journal going, and so I think I clipped one phone call where one of the representative's brothers called in, but other than that, I was like, well, I can use this clip, and it actually did pretty well, and it was our second most popular video that day after this one, which got 53,000 views. Any questions? That was pretty much a basic search, going back over 10 years, and then making a clip. We did the download and uploaded. Questions? Okay.
Like guidance on like sourcing and things like that, your preferences if we're going to be doing this. It's all labeled C-SPAN, so it's like,
don't block out our logo,
right?
Is the first thing I would say. We've had people do that, and that's when I send an email sometimes or make a phone call. Don't block out our logo, but a lot of this is under the fair use. If you're using it for other reasons, down here at the bottom of C-SPAN, there's a licensing.
Yeah, way down the bottom.
Way down at the bottom, copyright. That's usually people who use it in a documentary.
Oh, okay.
But we constantly see clips in various videos from Politico and Roll Call and the Washington Post, as long as we always get credit there. And usually, it's less than a minute, so it's not a big thing. But this copyright and licensing, we get calls all the time for people to use it in movies, documentaries, things like that.
Thanks.
Cool. Yeah. All right, we're going to do a different search now. Was there another one? Yeah.
Sort of like a follow-up on that. So like I work for a regional newspaper.
Right.
If you want to do embed, but if we are embed, usually comes with pre-roll. Is that all okay or no or?
I mean, we've seen plenty of people use pre-roll. Our videos have pre-rolls for our programs on it as
right.
well, and they're embeddable. So whether or not you're putting them in your video or just embedding ours, either way. Okay. Yeah.
I was going to ask the same question as him, just for the people in the room that might want to put the articles in there or like put the video in their articles. What's convenient is our pre-rolls are only 3 seconds long,
mm-hmm.
So they're not cumbersome by any means.
The transcripts are, how close to verbatim are they, and do you have any search terms that, or is it Boolean, or, because I've had trouble sometimes searching quotes and...
Yeah, a couple things I'll say about transcripts. First, we always say to use them as a guide. Don't copy and paste and put that in your article, because then when you say, when someone fact checks you and it's not right, I'm not going to apologize. So use them as a guide, but double check everything. They're also in all caps as well,
right.
And so you can't just put those right in an article. They're usually pretty close, actually. I would say if you know the term you're looking for, it's easier to search for that rather than a needle in a haystack. Hey, did this person ever say, I don't even know, that they're opposed to something like a border wall. It's easier to go through if you know something's there. Sometimes a congressional record is slightly more accurate, but that can be a little more cumbersome to search sometimes. So use it as a guide. It's not perfect, and it takes some time to load as well. Also, our transcripts only go back about, I think, until about the year 2000, so anything before that, like if you're looking for something from the Clinton administration, sometimes I try to go to a site off of C-SPAN to try to find the actual transcript. So State of the Union, sometimes we might not have the transcript for a Clinton State of the Union, but that's various other places, Library of Congress has that, and then you can match it up with a video. It just might take a little more time.
Okay.
Back there, yeah.
What about using just the audio? Is the same rules apply?
I believe so, as long as you give us credit. All right, I'm going to do a different search, and then we'll get back to some more questions. We're going to go for, Obama. And this specific search, I'm going to tell you, is something that I'm probably going to tweet from C-SPAN later today, so I'm giving you a little preview of something we'll do. And I was just curious, and actually I'm going to give credit to my boss for finding this first. And I'm going to put in the term border fence. As you can see, nothing comes up except if I hit mentions. And there's two, one from when he was president, and the other from this Senate session back in 2006.
I have some badly, I rise to...
Okay.
Senator Miller.
Yeah, okay. We're not going to watch this whole thing, but I'll stop it here in just a second to watch this.
Okay, we're going to quorum call. I ask the quorum call be terminated.
Without objection.
Mr. President, I rise to speak about the Security Fence Act. The bill before us will certainly do some good. It will authorize some badly needed funding for better fences and better security along our borders, and that should help stem some of the tide of illegal immigration in this country.
So I can pause it there, and you could probably clip that and do all sorts of things with that. Yeah, Dan.
Did Howard tweet that?
It's possible.
Okay.
He just stepped out?
Yeah.
He told me to ask that right now.
Yeah. Howard tweeted part of this. So we saw the first part. Let's watch the second part of this.
But if we think that putting up a few more miles of fence is by any means the whole answer to our immigration problems, then I believe we're seriously kidding ourselves. This bill, from my perspective, is...
We see this constantly. We see people, and President Obama was really well known for this, where he would say one thing and then kind of elaborate beyond that and say, but that's not the entire answer, or that's not everything you need for this argument. So when I tweet this out later today, his complete remarks right here are only 5 minutes long. I will do the entire 5 minutes from C-SPAN, okay? Not just the first 30 seconds. Howard's back. Howard's the one who stumbled on this weekend. Howard's the inspiration. But Howard's Twitter account, unlike C-SPAN, can only do 90 seconds worth of video. And so C-SPAN's going to do the full 5 minutes later today. And so we have seen this... one point, Obama did a tweet, campaign rally in Richmond, and he talked about government helping local business, and he said something like, you didn't build that. Actually, let's find that real quick. Actually, I'll just say it. We're not going to find it. But he said that. It was used in all sorts of campaign ads. Some from Republicans who said he really didn't believe in local business or local government, and others showed a longer version where he was saying that local business were supported by government infrastructure and all sorts of things like that set up. It was very interesting to see that clip used in various ways and just the context of which was changed slightly. But I'm going to talk more about this and the Secure Fence Act. This is from 2006, so it's HR 6061. Now, if you go back to the search here, or up top, we've got this tab that says Congress. But right down here, I'm going to view this in the Congressional Chronicle. The Congressional Chronicle, and I could spend a half hour just on this, is really just everything on the Hill related to, I mean, really legislation on the Hill. So this is not going to have the Washington Journal, it's not going to have Newsmakers, it's not going to have Q&A, it's not going to have Brookings Institute. This is just things on the Hill. So for this particular day, September 21st, 2006, we can look at what happened that day. I want to go just to the bill. And I think the number was 6061.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
And it's an HR right there, so we'll search for that. So, I went to the wrong Congress. Hold on. 6061, we want the 109th Congress. And here it is. So, it was sponsored by Peter King. Let's go down to all 30 actions. It was introduced here on September 13th, 2006. Go through and you can see every single thing that happened. And if this green play button or blue play button is on the left, there's a video related to it. And so you can see when cloture was invoked, and here's when it was passed by the Senate. Let's go to that. We're just going to click play. That goes right to the date of the vote. This is about a week after Obama gave those remarks. And you can see.
But
we're going to give a second.
Fine. Mr. Bennett.
This is the vote.
Mr. Biden.
And then you can skip ahead. This vote was probably open for about 20 minutes.
Mr. Conrad. Horner.
Or longer.
Who makes those bullet point graphics?
I think they're generated by the our archives out in Indiana. I'm not going to go to passage. This bill passed 80 to 20.
Yeah.
And then you can also see down here, I think, how everyone voted. Here's all 60 amendments. Oh, where's the vote? All four co-sponsors. I know there's a vote in here somewhere. Hang on. I had this up 20 minutes ago. Anyways, you can go in here and actually see who voted yes, who voted no. Those are all the co-sponsors. It's in here somewhere. But basically, 80 senators voted yes, including Obama, including Biden. John Kerry voted no on it. It's just kind of interesting. And so we'll probably do some work on that this afternoon. Questions? The one thing I always tell people about using our site is make sure you use it. Just try to poke around there every once in a while, because if push comes to shove and you haven't used it in 3 months and now you need to find something because you're on deadline, there's a lot here. I mean, there's a quarter century worth of video, and some of these videos are 27 hours long, and finding that right 30 seconds is not always something you can do in 2 minutes. It sometimes might take you a lot longer. So I would just say, try to, you know, come on here every once in a while, keep yourself familiar with it, know your login. It took me about 4 times to log in because I'm always logged in on my computer at my desk. So those are just some tips. If you have any questions, and I've still got another clip to show, but I will say, feel free to send me an email or send me a tweet, C-Fan Jeremy, and I'm happy to help. If you ever encounter a problem, like I said, probably not my fault, but I'll try to fix it for you. And so that is kind of the video library in a nutshell. Searching is a big part of it. Making clips is a huge part of it, because there's nothing I hate more than when someone posts a video on Facebook and says, go to the 47-minute mark of this video and watch for 30 seconds to see my point. It's a lot easier to just make a clip. and use that as you see fit. Questions? Okay, last thing I'll show. Reporters aren't the only folks who use a video library. So I'll show you one example. This is an event that happened 2010. House Republicans went out to a hardware store in Sterling, Virginia. I think it's Sterling. Yeah, Sterling, Virginia, a pledge to America. This event is 42 minutes long. It started, we'll go down here. It started at 10:03. It was on C-SPAN 3. So it ended at about, 10:45. And then this guy, if anyone remembers him, recorded his show every day, I think at 4 o'clock. So this was less than 5.5 hours later. I'm going to show you what he did. There are going to be clips from that hardware store event and then clips from the video library. I'm just going to let it play.
If I'm not mistaken, your fresh new ideas sound slightly like, I'm sorry, did I say slightly? Exactly like your old ideas.
Rein in the Washington, D.C. red tape.
Cut Washington red tape.
Act immediately to reduce spending.
Have real reforms to reduce spending.
Change the way we do business in Washington.
Change business as usual in Washington.
Make the tax cuts permanent.
Make the existing tax cuts permanent.
Health savings accounts that puts the patient firmly in control.
Health savings accounts, which will give families more control.
Reduce the size of our government.
Reducing the size of government.
A smaller, less costly.
Less costly.
And more accountable
government, for government
in our nation's capital.
Seth Meyers, Jimmy Fallon, all those guys, late night. I constantly watch to see what they use of ours and how they use it. It's really kind of cool to see what they do and how quickly they do it. And examples like that, I've got several of those that I'll just happen upon. And so as the campaign starts up and we see who gets into the race, we're going to see which videos make appearances. I always cheer for the people who have been on C-SPAN the most. Trump was not on C-SPAN a whole lot before he ran for president, but he had been on C-SPAN several times before. I will tell you right now, Joe Biden gets into it. We have thousands of Joe Biden videos. And I know that I've been at conferences where candidates come up and make sure that they have a staffer who knows everything they said before and whether or not it's going to be used against them or if they have an answer ready for things like that. It's always interesting to see when someone's nominated for a post, if they've been on C-SPAN before and the things they've said. That's one of the things Howard and I do a lot, is to see how many prior C-SPAN appearances there are. It was really interesting. I think Gina Haspel, the CIA director, had never been on C-SPAN before. And so now the only videos of her are as CIA director, and kind of we're like, wow, if you're going to be in intelligence, that's a way to do it. anyway, yes?
For that Stewart clip, you had to guess how he did that. When he pulls, was that like keyword searching those phrases?
Yeah, I'm guessing he went through exactly and said, cut Washington red tape. He probably searched red tape and just went through until he found a Republican and could see if it was a prominent Republican or the same Republican that was at the event. Mm-hmm. That's the thing with John Boehner's, with thousands and thousands of appearances, it was pretty likely that he had said something like that. And we all know that we'll see, I mean, with stump speeches, people repeat things over and over and over again. And so whether or not it's on the floor or at an event, it can be somewhat easy to find if you know they said it. I always think the video library is easiest to find if you know what you're looking for. If I know that I saw the president make the speech at some point, it's in there. If I'm just hoping that Obama made a speech about the border wall, I could have done it for hours, not realizing that he called it a fence. And so if I knew it was called a fence, it's easy to find. But sometimes those needle in the haystack type things are just there, you happen upon them, and then you tweet it out. Yes?
So you earlier showed like how to look for things that are just on the Hill. And if you're looking in the library for, our previous speakers talked about, the Road to the White House events and also like state level government events.
Right.
Can you talk about like how to, can you do not Congress only, but everything but Congress?
Sure.
Is that, I don't know.
Let's see. This is always Howard's part of saying this is the stump Jeremy part. We're going to search.
That wasn't my intention.
No, it's fine. So I'm going to just pick Tim Pawlenty. And I believe, I probably should have picked someone who got elected to something on the Hill. But over here on the left, you can see event type. You can also see location.
Okay.
Or the series. Actually, let's go to Elizabeth Warren. That's probably easier. Okay, so, Elizabeth Warren. ...484 appearances. So we can go down here on the left and just pick things in the Senate. We can just pick Road to the White House. So even though she just went to Iowa, how do we already have four? Oh, because she campaigned for Hillary Clinton, her speech at the convention, and then, it looks like we didn't even call what happened this past week. We haven't tagged it with Road to the White House yet. Well, that's Road to the White House 2016. I wonder if there's a different 2020 tag in here. If not, there will be. Here's state races, so you can think.
Okay.
So that's kind of how you can break it down.
Great, thanks. I just didn't know what the series tab was. That's helpful.
There's also location on here, so these are sometimes pretty broad, but you can find something like just when she's in Boston. Specifically, if you know, it's like, I know she made a speech, I can't remember what week it was, I can't remember what it was about, but I know it was in Boston, and you can narrow it down from there. Cool.
Thanks.
Other questions? We've got 2 minutes left.
On the Jon Stewart clip or other clips, how good are they about crediting you guys properly?
They don't block out the logo, and usually that's it. They don't mention C-SPAN a whole lot. Sometimes they do, although sometimes when they mention C-SPAN, it's a punchline, and so... you know, any mention we can get, but usually they don't block out the logos.
So
and
that Stewart clip you just showed us, I wasn't paying attention, were the logos in there?
I think they were.
Okay.
Yeah. Other questions? If you have questions, let me know. Send me a tweet, send me an email, and we look forward to seeing how you guys use the site. When we first unveiled the video library 8-9 years ago, hardly anyone was really using it, and now all the time we see other people using the site. It's kind of fun and interesting to see how people use it. Yeah.
Do you run trainings like the multimedia team at my outlet?
Yes.
Would like love to like sit here for 20 minutes with you and learn how to do this.
Yes.
Some of them are pros, new people, I feel like this is so valuable.
I'll give you my card. That's exactly what we'd love to do, is just have you guys come sit in a conference room with us. We'll run through kind of some of the basics that I just did for 20 minutes. And then really let you guys ask questions, and we'll kind of walk you through as much as we can.
In a more intimate setting. So
much more.
Yeah.
You can sort of share some of the things that you're working on, and we can help you with that as well.
Or we can do this conference room, have you guys sit over there also here and keep our distance. But yes, if you'd like to do that, I'll give you my card. Feel free to send us a note. We're happy to host you guys in smaller groups and walk you through everything.
Okay.